Welcome to the FoxLearn. Today we will learn how to back up a database. First, we will design a simple UI allows you to connect to the SQL server, then you can enter database name for backup. You need to include in your project four libraries. the type of device you go into backup, database, files or log, the SQL database name you need to backup. Keep in mind that the file path you use here is relative to the SQL server, not your local file system. Leaving the initialize value set to the default to false will create a new backup item as the last backup set. If you change the initialize value to true, then this backup set will become the first backup set and will overwrite other backups that have the same backup set name. If you use multithreading to improve the performance of your Windows Forms applications, you must make sure that you make calls to your controls in a thread-safe way. Access to Windows Forms controls is not inherently thread-safe. If you have two or more threads manipulating the state of a control, it is possible to force the control into an inconsistent state. Other thread-related bugs are possible, such as race conditions and deadlocks. It is important to make sure that access to your controls is performed in a thread-safe way. The .NET framework provides methods that are safe to call from any thread for invoking methods that interact with controls owned by other threads. The invoke method allows for the synchronous execution of methods on controls, whereas the begin invoke method initiates asynchronous execution. To use these methods, you must declare a delegate with the same signature as the method you will be invoking. Then you can call the invoke or begin invoke method of any control on the form by supplying the appropriate delegate to the method you want to call. Thank you for watching this video.